السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, Allah loves those who are clean and Allah loves those who are pure. We have to purify the heart and we have to clean ourselves externally as well as internally. Remember, the Almighty says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Allah loves those who constantly repent and those who cleanse themselves. This is verse number 222 of Surah Al-Baqarah. So my brothers and sisters, if you look at cleanliness, while we must keep our hands clean, while we must wash ourselves, while we must actually clean ourselves in a specific way 5 times a day to make ourselves ready for the prayer, we must make sure that our clothes are clean, our surrounding is clean, the environment is clean, the house is clean, the bedding is clean, the food we eat is clean. All this is part of the goodness that the Almighty expects from us. Now, the Almighty only tells us to do that which is actually beneficial for us. So it can never be that He's instructed us something and it's not good for us. It has to be beneficial. It will be. Whether we understand it or not, sometimes disease spreads and we don't realize that the Almighty had granted us a gift by teaching us about cleanliness, so it did not spread as much amongst us. However, at times, it's just a lesson for us to appreciate what the Almighty has actually revealed. So we become more conscious of the cleanliness factor. That's a gift of Allah. You want comfort in times of crisis? Make sure that you keep yourselves clean. Make sure you clean your heart, like I said. Because what's the point of having such a good-looking outward appearance? And your hands are clean and everything else is smart, your clothes are ironed very well, you're looking very neat with your haircut and whatever else it might be, but the way you speak is so bad, your heart is dirty, filled with disease, filled with hatred, jealousy, deception, and so on. If we cleanse ourselves, we will definitely be able to achieve the comfort. Allah says, He loves those who seek forgiveness, and He also loves those who are very, very clean. So if you were to seek forgiveness from the Almighty, then you would automatically have to clean your heart, because the two go together, hand in hand. You clean your heart, you seek the forgiveness of the Almighty, He forgives you, and you have a big heart to forgive others as well.